Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our online classes. Right now, I am in the 9th standard first language English class. So, in the previous class, we already understand the beautiful concept about a poem that is a Bold Peddler and the Robin Hood. So, that poem already completed and I already sent you the textual question and the answers. I hope you should complete that fair. So, you should take the signature on the Saturday. Now, it is the time to understand the new poem that is Geography Lesson. Geography Lesson is one of the geographical thoughtful poem composed by Zulfikar Ghosh. Zulfikar Ghosh was the poet of the Geography Lesson. So, in this manner, we have to understand what are the ideal things he has mentioned in this poem. Before I am going to start this poem, we have to observe the little information about the poet introduction. So, everyone should open your textbook, page number 143. So, in that page number, there is a little information about the poet. After receiving the poet introduction, we have to move towards the very first stanza. So, here the introduction of Zulfikar Ghosh. He was born in the Sialkot of India. It is right now in Pakistan, not in India. But here, before we got freedom, that place included in India. So, where he was born? Zulfikar Ghosh was born in the Sialkot of India. Where is it right now? The next one, on March 13, 1935. When did he was born there? Zulfikar Ghosh was born on March 13th in the year of 1935. So the next one is, he is a novelist, a poet and an essayist. So Zulfikar Ghosh has three kinds of variety person. So he has three quality in the literature awareness. That is, the first one is, he is a novelist and he is a poet and he is an essayist. So he wrote so many essays, he wrote so many novels and he creates so many poets on the basis of the subjectual matters. So in this way he has three kinds of qualities in literature. The next point is that after the partition of India, Ghosh and his family emigrated to England. Emigrated means migrated. They are Zulfikar Ghosh and his family. After partition of India and Pakistan, he migrated to England. He shifted to England with his family. The next point is that where he completed his education and took up the teaching profession. He started his life career in England and also he became a teacher and he became a professional teacher. He was one of the professor in that England colleges. The next one is that later he went to America and since then he has lived in Texas. So, Texas is the name of the city in America. He lived at present there. So, after completion of his profession period of in England, he went to America. So, until after completion of his profession period, he is living in that place of America. The city of America is Texas. So, it is a brief information about the poet Zulfikar Ghosh. Now, it is the time to understand warm-up activity. So, dear students, you should complete that work, warm-up activity. It is the humble request of the poet. Why? Because what kind of previous sense or knowledge we have before you have to understand this geography lesson. So, the very first question he asked to you, that is the first question is there, why do we have compound walls for our houses? It's a one of the complicated questions to you for so many. That means he wanted to three opinions. That's why he has given three numbers. According to that number, you should give to me three opinions. Once again, I repeat that question. That question is, why do we have compound walls for our houses? You should answer with three opinions. The next one is, imagine if the city corporation passed a law to abolish compound walls, what would happen in your locality? Discuss. There is one more question he asked. In the surrounding your area, you are staying under the municipality or city corporation area, the city corporation passed a law to abolish compound walls, what would happen in your locality? There is an angriness or quarrel, fight with each other. That's why you have to understand and answer these two questions sent to the group. We have to directly start the very first stage of the geography lesson. This is the beautiful poem composed by, once again, Zulfikar Ghosh. What he expresses in his very first stanza: when the jet sprang into the sky, it was clear why the city had developed the way it had, seeing it scale 6 inches to the mile. Just you have to understand, his imagination is developing in this first stanza. What is the imagination? When the jet sprung means the jet airlines is flying over the sky or into the sky, it was clear by the city. So when we have to observe that aeroplane, it's clearly observed us. Why? Because the city is very clear. The second point is that had developed the way it had. How the cities had developed it. That means if the aeroplane is not clearly appear to us, what will happen? We have to understand the city corporation is not maintenance, the city is not clean. That's why in this manner he expressed his thoughts about the city corporation. Here the next point is that seeing it scaled 6 inches to the mile. So the very small thing of the aeroplane is very clearly appear to us, but not other things are. That means there is a sense. What is the word? Sense is here, geography means that earth, graphy means study. The systematic study of the earth is considered geography. That's why the aeroplane is clearly observed us because of the earth has a gravitation power. The main concept is the first stanza. He mainly explained about that geography. When we have to learn geography, at the time we are very careful and very awareness about our surroundings. So in this manner, in the first stanza he expressed about that geography. That means systematic study of the earth is very important. That's why the city corporation cleaned the city. That's why the air is very clear. We have to easily appear that aeroplane. So this is the meaning of the first stanza. In the next class, we have to understand the rest of other stanzas. Okay? Thank you.